ever to have try to have conversations when you're angry. Like, that's not the, because so when we got home, she was angry or whatever, and I was kind of like, well, why the hell you hit me? But like, you can't solve it in the middle of anger. And here's the problem with most married couples. You don't, like, especially most married couples who we counsel and that end up beefing and stuff like that, what happens is they don't ever talk about their marriage until something's wrong, right? So like, in the heat of that moment, however mad she was, and I got mad because she hit me, and we get back home and we trying to fix whatever that is in the moment right there, it's never gonna happen. I could be like, yo, the grass is green, and she'd be like, no, it's not, it's blue. She could be like, yo, the sky's blue, and I'm like, no, it's not, it's green, because you're trying to win an argument, right? Like, so when you think about having a argument or whatever, the goal of an argument or a debate is to win. So now we're on opposite teams. But what happens is, we try to help our married friends with this. We say, hey, if there's a real issue, hey, we're not spending enough time together, you're not active enough with the kids. If there's something that's going wrong, what they'll do, what most of y'all do, is you wait till it bubbles all the way up, and then you have a big argument in the kitchen, and you go, you don't even spend enough time with the kids, and we ain't there having sex enough, and you ain't, and you're just trying to win an argument. So everything falls on deaf ears. So what we learn to do is have our check-ins, and here goes the thing. Most people are unwilling to do this because when it's smooth sailing and it's comfortable, I don't want to bring up no issue then. I'm not trying, right? I'm not trying to rock the boat right now, right? Like, we finally on one accord. We ain't arguing, we ain't yelling, we ain't doing none of that. I can finally say me and my wife is straight. You want me to bring up the fact I don't feel like we having enough sex or something right now? And it's like, yeah, that's actually the time to bring it up, because the person is going to be more receptive because it's not falling in an emotional state. But most people can't do that. So one thing we really learned early on was, okay, cool, it's not going to happen tonight. We ain't got to beef out, but this conversation, we could have it, you know, after we sleep it off and we just chill, right? For us, being on one accord, we talk about decisions. We work them out. We talk them through. We go to God about it, whether it be for the kids, whether it be, you know, for anything else. We really lock in and have those conversations. You look at most people who, again, we're talking about bliss now. Like, we wake up and, like, bliss, like, for real, like, texting each other, like, love you, you know, everything, every day. So in order to do that, and I'm just thinking, like, y'all, first of all, we surround ourselves with couples who have that type of energy, which is why having Marlon and Camille in our lives has been such a blessing, because it's like, yo, here go people who, like, you can go and be your 100% self with on vacation or, you know, wherever else. And we have several couples, you know, in our circle who you can do that with. Not, it's not a surprise, right? We tend to surround ourselves with people like us. But having that example of, yo, how do you not fall victim to what everybody else does, right? You see people, and after 15 years, they like, man, I could just speak for the people in my life. When I was growing up, they'd be like, oh, you getting married? Why are you getting married? What time's the funeral? It was always like a negative. You know, that was always like a it was always like a negative thing to, like, oh, the old ball and chain. Like, all the stuff that you hear that's supposed to be a joke, but, you know, it got some truth to it. You know what I'm saying? And I was always like, man, this is a decision I'm making to marry this person. Like, nobody got a gun to my head making me marry her. So, like, why not be in the most blissful position we could possibly be in?